What's going on, guys and gals? King Spin here, and we're going to do a review on the Hawk and Housewife box. Just hit the store, obviously. And I'm not impressed. Again, I don't really think any of the first rotation boxes are going to be worth going in on. They're too scattered. You've got like a disguised and armed and then two fighters in the epics, and they're all crap. You've got Krav Maga Dale, 38 health, not even skills are meh. Hawk and Chick, 47 health. I mean, it'll hold a slot for a second, but it's got attack boost and motivate, only 9 actual attacks, so even the punch that it's going to get off of the BGE effect isn't going to be something worth having. For characters, you've got Bobby, who's, it's good to have him. I mean, he's got a few BGEs where he's really good. This doesn't look to be one of them to me, but, you know, Bobby's still Bobby. Bender's always a good one to have. He's got a lot of BGEs where he's really good. Gender Bender is really good in the current BGE. So, I mean, he's worth having. But then you've got Red Shirt, Blue Shirt, which is a musical card. And I've told everyone before, I don't think it's all that great of a card, even on BGE, much less during this time. You've got Butterscotch Cookies, which, from what I'm aware of, is the only legendary addicted card in the game right now. But I don't think that the combos I've got researched for it so far are all that great. I haven't really looked into what else it makes yet. I just research it when I have nothing else going on. But I wouldn't be chasing in this box after it. Capoeira, one of the first rotation fighter cards. It's not really great either. I mean, stats, skills, all around, it's just not great. And Will of a Housewife, supposed to be the draw of the box with the 12 punch, the 7 craze, the 10 base attack, and the 56 health. And again, like with the rest of the first rotation PCs, I'm not really impressed with this either. So I'm not going to be pulling on this box at all. I'll just let it pass. I'll be looking for next week's new box to see what comes out in it, and I'm still hoping that the small mythic bundle will be the next one to rotate into the store now that the regular mythic bundle's gone, because I'll pick one or two of those up and finish out my special pulls on the Christmas punch-out box over here. Because it's a much better box. I mean, No Mercy Dojo and Capoeira, still not great. But Diamond Crusher's good, Christmas Punch-Out is good, the Peters and Fries are good, the Zoidberg versus Bot was usable, so it was a better box, and I wouldn't mind getting a hold of another Diamond Crusher, because I've got one from my turd pulls. And of course, Christmas Punch-Out, I mean, I think it's the best new PC out. I mean, there are some people with some other opinions on which one might be the best one, like Action Force Leela. And I'm not going to argue that that's a great card. We'll do a better review on it once it comes out. But I like this one better personally, so that is what it is. But that's pretty much going to cover it. Like I said, I'm not going to be doing any pulls. If you do some pulls on it, you know, let me know what you get. It's always cool to see what everybody else is getting out of a box. And that'll cover it. So y'all be cool, be safe, be careful, and we'll catch you next time.